Good morning, Michael. Baseball is America's pastime, and as summer approaches, youth baseball is getting underway for millions of kids from coast to coast.
When kids first start out playing Little League, it's all about the love of the game.
I love this time of year. Sun is out, and Little League season is here.
Who's going to get a hit today? Yay!
But before long, the pressure to win pushes some kids into playing baseball year-round or in multiple teams. Dr. Jeffrey Dugas says more and more kids are suffering long-term injuries. The first sign of a problem? Little League elbow, a painful precursor to the condition that leads to reconstructive elbow surgery, or what's known as Tommy John surgery. Repetitive throwing can cause increased stress to the growth plate in the inner part of the elbow, resulting in inflammation. In some cases, the growth plate gets separated from the bone, which may require surgery.
Leagues will start pitching around age 9, and that's when it starts. And that's the real shame in this, is some of these kids end up not being able to continue and play a sport they love.
Jack Traffenstead is one of the lucky ones. He's been playing baseball since he was 5, but the 13-year-old pitcher recently tore part of the growth plate in his throwing elbow from the bone.
Right when I came through, about right here, is when I felt it.
And he had pulled off a little bit of the growth plate where the Tommy John ligament attaches, and that explains the pop and the oh no, that really hurt.
But Dr. Dugas determined that Jack's injury did not require surgery. Yet for Jack's mother, Jody, it was a real wake-up call.
We didn't expect the diagnosis. I was thinking tendonitis, inflammation. I was shocked.
And while demanding sports parents have made headlines in recent years, mom and dad aren't always to blame.
In the end, the parents get hyper-competitive, but the kids do too.
It's hard for him because he comes home and he'll get in the car and he'll say, well, this person threw so many strikes today. And, you know, in his mind, he's worried about players getting, you know, taking his spot.
I love it. I want the coaches to give me as much as they want to give me.
What's the one thing you miss the most?
Striking other kids out.
Who doesn't want to strike other kids out?
Dr. Dugas says Jack should be able to play again in just a few months. Meanwhile, he has a message for all parents.
I would say at all times it should be fun. That's the thing that the parents have to get across, is that winning is not the only part of having fun. Playing the game is still having fun, and they have to enjoy just the playing of the game, not the winning of the game.
More serious injuries like reconstructive elbow surgery used to be seen in college and pro athletes, but now with a recent study, nearly 60% of Tommy John surgeries are at the high school level, some kids as young as 13 years old. And there are three main ways, according to the American Sports Medicine Institute, that we can prevent this. One is if you're tired, if you feel that pain in your elbow or shoulder, stop. The whole idea of playing through it, don't do it. The second is when you think about overhand throwing. Take 2 to 3 months a year, sometimes even 4 months, and just don't throw overhand, whether it's baseball, football, go climb a tree, go have fun. And the third is making sure that you're not trying to light up a radar gun. I feel like this is the biggest one, that max effort. You're 9, 10, 11 years old. What happened to just the purity of playing catch and not trying to throw the ball as hard as you can?
Well, you know what, Jessica, it's kind of like the how much do you bench? You know, it's just a challenging thing for most kids out there.